Good morning, children. Welcome to class 5 bridge course of social studies. So today in this class we are going to see about the physical conditions, children. So if you observe, so many landforms are there in India, like deserts, mountains, you have plains, okay, islands like that. So you would have seen in picture how a desert will look from your textbook or from news like that, and all you would have seen. So here the same thing, India is a land of diversity, children. So it has got different landforms. So I am telling the word landforms. It can be a mountains, plateaus, islands like that, desert. So these different landforms are there. So according to that, it has been divided into 6 divisions, children. So one by one we are going to see the northern mountains, the great northern plains, the western desert, the southern plateau, the coastal plains, the islands. So you should know the meaning, children. So as you have read last year, again we are revising it. First comes the northern mountains. So on the northern side you have the Himalayas, children. So it is a long stretch of mountains, okay. So I am showing it over here. See, from the north, from Jammu Kashmir, it goes up to here, children, till the northeast. Still down the extension is there, but as we say, the northern mountains, it is up to this Himalaya stretch. Full stretch we will tell as Himalayan mountain ranges. Okay, Himalayan mountain ranges. So in that also divisions are there. One more class we will see Himalayan mountain ranges. So in that only you have the highest mountain, children, that is Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga, like that you have so many highest mountains in the world are present, okay. And then so these Himalayan mountains gives rise to so many rivers, children. First one is Ganga, Yamuna, and Brahmaputra. So these are major rivers, children. These are major rivers from the mountain ranges. The rivers originating from the mountain ranges are Ganga, Yamuna, and Brahmaputra. So you could have visualized, children. So you people would have gone to hill stations like that. So what do you observe? As the rivers form from the mountains, they flow through the plains, children. So whatever the river form, it flows through this northern plains. It is so wide and vast, okay. The area is very large, children, as these rivers fed this plains. They are called as the great northern plains. Wherever the Ganga, Yamuna, and Brahmaputra flows, no, all these areas comes under the great northern plains, children. This land is very fertile, as it brings lots of silt. It gets deposited on the riverside, and the water is also very nutritious, so the plants grow well in the soil. The next one is your western desert. Okay, on the Indian map, you have the western desert over here, children. There you can find the Thar Desert. Thar Desert. So it is a sandy plains are there. So sometimes the sand will form dunes, sand dunes. Sometimes the wind storm, so that there is a the sand gets blown up. So everywhere you get a sand storm over there. From the seas you get the cyclone, no, like that. In desert also you will have the sand storm, too. Okay, the next one you have the southern southern plateau. It is one of the oldest mountain land. Okay, before Himalayas formed, you know, this southern plateau were formed. So that's why I'm telling it is the oldest land mass too. So it comprises Madhya Pradesh, our southern states like Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu too. Okay, the next two one coastal plains. Okay, so after southern plateau, the sites near to the sea, you know, is both on the western side and on the eastern side. You have the west and the eastern coastal plains. They are also fertile children because the rivers flow through most of the eastern parts and the western parts. So they are also fertile. So on the eastern side, you have the Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, like that. So they form delta, and it is a fertile region too. So the next one is your islands. So what are the islands you can find over here in the Arabian Sea? You have Lakshadweep Islands, and in the Bay of Bengal, you have the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Okay, these two islands are there, children. Lakshadweep Islands and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. One more point I want to tell children. You would have heard about Kanyakumari or Cape Comorin. That is the southernmost tip of India. The last end we will tell, you know, that is Kanyakumari or Cape Comorin. Then, but India has got Andaman and Nicobar Islands, you know. So considering that, our last tip is Indira Point. Okay, Indira Point in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So we have to see detail in map, children. Learn the India map. It's very important. Okay, see you in the next class.